Welcome to Anti-Vlogmas number 17 out of 25. And this is Friday, so we finish our homeschool. We do our homeschool Mondays through Thursdays year-round, taking a month of July off. And Friday is usually our errands day and when we get groceries and things like that. And we have a rainy day right now. It stopped raining for a little bit, but we're going again. It's kind of nice, though. It's cold and rainy, though. So we're getting ready now. We're going to head out and run our errands. It is so rainy and dreary and dark all day today. But anyways, we went out, ran our errands, got groceries, and did all that fun stuff, got back. I did our budget. I paid our bills. And now here I am. So actually, in a little bit, it'll be time for my husband and I to do our date. But first, I just wanted to jump on really quick and share with you another reason, just a tidbit of another reason why I don't celebrate Christmas. So in the Bible, if you turn to Deuteronomy chapter 5, and you might recognize Exodus chapter 20 and Deuteronomy chapter 5 are the two places in the Bible where you have the Ten Commandments. Okay, and then chapter 5, and then let's just look at verses 7 through 10. All right, so starting with verse 7, it says, "Thou hast no other gods in my presence." Do you have other gods in the presence of the one true God this Xmas season? Verse 8, "Thou dost not make to thee a graven image, any similitude which is in the heavens above, or which is in the earth beneath, and which is in the waters under the earth. Thou dost not bow thyself to them, nor serve them. For I, Jehovah, thy God, am a zealous God, charging iniquity of fathers on children, and on a third generation, and on a fourth, and on those hating me, and doing kindness to thousands, to those loving me, and to those keeping my commands." So notice here, though, in verse 8, or in verse 9, it says, "Thou dost not bow thyself to them, nor serve them." It doesn't say, don't bow to them and serve them, or don't worship them and serve them. It says, don't bow to them, nor serve them. So, serving is when you're doing an action that is for the benefit or a ritual towards something or someone else. So when you are doing these pagan festivities of Christmas, you are serving the demons of Christmas. The Christmas spirit is a demon, and you are serving that demon through your actions. That demon doesn't care about your heart or your beliefs or if you're worshiping. It just cares if it's getting service from you, because if you're serving that demon, then you are putting other gods before the one true God. Verse 7, "Thou hast no other gods in my presence." And notice it also went into idols. And then we know the Christmas tree is specifically a type of idol, because we read about that in Jeremiah chapter 10. So if you have a Christmas tree in your house and you claim to be a child of God, you have a lowercase g god in the presence of God, and you are serving a lowercase g god. And that is against the Ten Commandments. Now, let's move over to the next chapter over, staying in Deuteronomy. Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 6, and let's just take a look at verses 13 through 15. So starting in verse 13, it says, "Jehovah thy God dost thou fear, and him dost thou serve, and by his name thou dost swear. Ye do not go after other gods, of the gods of the people who are round about you. For a zealous God is Jehovah thy God in thy midst, lest the anger of Jehovah thy God burn against thee, and he hath destroyed thee from off the face of the ground." So, who are we supposed to serve? Well, it says here that we're only supposed to serve, verse 13, "and him, Jehovah, thou dost serve." Okay, and then what about the gods of the peoples of the land round about you? Well, this season, that would be the Xmas gods, the demons behind the pagan festivities of Christmas. All right, and it says we're not supposed to go after them. So going after them would be for putting up their idols, the Christmas tree in our house, and the stockings, and the womb wreaths. And if we're casting presents at the foot of a tree, if we are making merry, like the Israelites did at the foot of Mount Sinai, where they were holding a feast to God, but they decided to make merry and rise up and play and give some credence to some of those false gods that they remembered from Egypt as well. So if you think that combining your heart being for God, but you're still following the festivities of the world and of Christmas, then know that you are guilty of what this is warning you against. All right, it says in verse 14, ye do not go after other gods of the peoples who are round about you. It's not saying you have to believe in them. It's not saying that you have to worship them. It's just saying not to go after them. Synonymous with, in the Ten Commandments, not to serve them. We are a peculiar people. We are not of this world. We shouldn't be partaking of the religious festivities of this world. And that is today's little tidbit as for another reason why I don't partake of Christmas or any of its pagan festivities. And now I am going to get a few things wrapped up, and my husband and I are going to head out on our date. Hubby and I are heading out on our date. I'm wearing my super snazzy night vision glasses, and we are in Fog World driving through clouds.